I lost my mother to breast cancer in 1983, and then in 1992, I was diagnosed with breast cancer. And we want to know what causes breast cancer.
Woman by woman, sister by sister, we can make a difference. That's the motto for the Sister Study, the nation's largest long-term study looking into the environmental and genetic causes of breast cancer. It started 20 years ago when the director of the National Institute of Environmental Health Sciences, Dr. Kenneth Olden, asked a small group of researchers to help address public concerns about the rising rates of breast cancer.
People were very concerned and emotional about these issues. And I could feel their pain. We needed this study, and we were never gonna get it unless somebody had the courage to just say, we're going to do this.
Before we had even finished the design, I remember that Dr. Olden went to Congress and told them we had the Sister Study, that no other institute had such a study. And so we were excited to get going.
We were able to secure the money from Congress to do the things that we have done.
The reason we studied sisters is that women share genes in common with their sisters, and they certainly share their early life environments. And so this would give us an increased ability to detect risks that were related to both environment and genes. We had no idea how we were going to get these women, but we started a national campaign, and we were successful in enrolling more than 50,000 women.
I think it's an easy study to love. It does involve some of the most passionate women that I personally have ever spoken to from every walk of life.
Here is this fabulous study, and that's what we all were looking for, this study.
As we mark the Sister Study's 20th anniversary, let's take a look at how women whose sisters had breast cancer have joined together with scientific investigators in a lasting commitment to help prevent breast cancer.
The most unique thing about the study is the study participants themselves. All of them have a reason to be here. They were affected by breast cancer in their families, and they want to make a difference, and they're very devoted to the study and excited to hear about our research and excited to help us get all the information that we need to do more research in the future.
One of my older sisters had breast cancer. So when the opportunity came up for somebody studying breast cancer and if it's, you know, genetic or where you live or things like that, I wanted to be able to help.
Seeing your sister fight breast cancer gives you a sense of total helplessness. And joining the Sister Study was a powerful way for me to do something that could make a difference.
The Sister Study is so unique and so special because it includes so many women from across the country who live in different places, have, you know, different exposures and lifestyles and interests, and it allows us to really explore such a wide range of risk factors to understand how they can act together to contribute to the risk of going on to develop breast cancer.
One of the highlights was when that decision was made to very intentionally include Puerto Rico to put the resources into translating all of the materials.
Sometimes as Hispanics, we shy away from publicity or, no, I don't want to do that. But we were trying to tell people, you have to do this. It's for our own good, it's for our children and great-granddaughters, great-great-granddaughters. We need to try and protect them at all times.
Pues agradezco al estudio de hermanas de forma casual y espontánea. Llegué a él, lo mucho que me ha ayudado en todos estos 20 años, la información que me ha dado, que para mí ha sido de gran crecimiento. Fue una forma hermosa y que yo aproveché porque ustedes hacían el estudio, hacían las inversiones y yo me crecí en conocimiento y eso para mí es maravilloso.
I think that the Sister Study opened the communication about breast cancer in a way that it didn't happen before. Within the Latino community, and I'm sure the African-American community and all communities.
We basically went where Black women were, as opposed to inviting them into spaces that were scientific, or we just went where they were and we brought the message and it resonated with a lot of them.
We've had more than 300 scientific papers that have come out of the Sister Study since we started. The Sister Study has carried out a wide range of research on breast cancer and also other diseases that are important for women. And it's hard to say what's like the most important thing that we've discovered. We looked at the use of beauty care products and stress and early life trauma, things that everybody experiences.
The study is a goldmine to understand the environmental causes for many chronic diseases besides cancer.
I think one of the most impactful findings that we've found in the Sister Study is on our work related to the use of chemical hair products. And so we found that women who used hair straighteners or relaxers were at a higher risk of developing breast, ovarian, and uterine cancer.
The important thing was that the women who were exposed to light at night while sleeping were also more likely to gain weight or become overweight while obese over time. Turning off lights, TV, and electronic at bedtime could reduce women's chance of becoming obese.
We've learned so much from the Sister Study data in terms of how social factors that indeed vary by race and ethnicity can contribute to preventable disparities in health. For instance, we've investigated traumatic childhood experiences such as physical and emotional abuse, which are commonly measured, as well as unique exposures like natural disasters, which are projected to increase due to climate change.
Using the resources of the Sister Study, I'm investigating how breast cancer diagnosis and treatment influences trajectories of biological aging, as well as changes in the immune system.
We're extremely grateful to all the women who've participated in the study. There would be no Sister Study without the women who are a part of this effort. I'm grateful not only to those who complete their questionnaires, but those who reach out to me and to the other researchers on our team to ask us questions and share their stories.
I want to thank you, Dale, too. You were kind enough, thoughtful enough, and I think bought in that you would take it on. And I knew it was a huge undertaking.
Response rates have been especially high, and considering how much we ask the women to do, how much information we collect from them, it's been a fabulous experience.
As an investigator of the Sister Study, I would like to sincerely thank all of the participants. Time is precious, and you spent your time advancing society through science, and so couldn't be more appreciative and grateful for your contributions. Thank you. I hope that you're learning as much as we're learning.
We feel very fortunate that the Sister Study continues to be funded, and we expect to continue the study for many years. We still have a lot to learn about how the environment contributes to breast cancer, and women's environments change as they get older. So we will be continuing with the study. We're studying the impact of heat and experiencing natural disasters and how those stressors relate to breast cancer risk.
Our research findings are making a difference in the world, and I've heard from countless women who have made changes in their use of hair products based on our study findings.
The Sister Study is an amazing study that's taught us so much. So scientifically, the study has been a big success. It's built a community of researchers, advocates, and study participants that are working together to find answers to very difficult questions. It's also nurtured young scientists who are using new technologies and innovative approaches that will carry this study into the future. It's an honor to celebrate the legacy of the Sister Study, and I want to keep it going for many years to come.
You guys are saving mothers and daughters and sisters. That's what you're doing. That's how big it is.
I'm grateful for any outcomes that the Sister Study can derive from all their research.
I have told everyone about the Sister Study and will continue as long as I have a breath to support our study.